आमचा चॅनल सबस्क्राइब करा आणि बेल आयकॉनवर क्लिक करून नवीन नवीन व्हिडिओचे नोटिफिकेशन्स मिळवा.
गुड आफ्टरनून टू एवरीवन. हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न 8th स्टँडर्ड इंग्लिश युनिट नंबर 3 लेसन नंबर 3. इट्स अ व्हेरी फॅन्टॅस्टिक मॉरलिस्टिक काइंड ऑफ अ पोयम ट्रूथ अँड द पोएट इज बॅरी वडे. डू वी स्पीक ट्रूथ ऑल द टाइम? आर यू रिमेंबर इन आवर डे टू डे लाईफ? कॅन वी स्पीक ट्रूथ ऑलवेज? आय थिंक नॉट ऑलवेज. समटाइम्स वी स्पीक लाईज. वाय? बिकॉज वी हाईड ट्रूथ आउट ऑफ फियर. समटाइम्स वी सेव एनी पर्सन अँड सो वी स्पीक लाईज. बट हियर द पोएट बॅरी वाडे हॅज इन दिस पोयम ही कम्पेअर्स वर्ड्स विथ द इन्स्ट्रुमेंट्स पेपर्स. आर यू थिंक अबाउट आवर वर्ड्स may affect another person's mind or heart? Absolutely. When we speak, when we use words, it directly affects the person's mind, sentiment, emotion, heart, because the mind, heart is very tender. It's a very delicate kind of, it's very soft. And the injuries, the hurt which is done at this part, mind, heart, sentiment, emotions, feelings, the mark, the injury, the hurt which is caused by our words, it remains for a long period. It remains forever. We can't easily forget the mark, the injuries, the hurt which is caused by such kind of a harsh words. So here the poet always told us, speaks us or give a very moralistic kind of a lesson that we should use the words very properly. We use the words very carefully and properly because it may affect another person's mind, heart and feelings, sentiments, emotions. So here he always he gives this lesson that while speaking we should use proper words. We use the words very carefully and this lesson given through this poem. Here the poet Barry Vade, the speaker of the poem is Barry Vade. Here he gives us such kind of a moralistic kind of a lesson. See the poem here. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words can also hurt me. Here Barry Vade told that sticks and stones break my bones. The instruments which cause our physical body, our skin, these are sticks, stones, bats, thorns, etc. They injure our body, physical body. But words can also hurt me. But he always told that, the speaker, Barry Vade always told that the words also hurt me. Such kind of a harsh words, bad words also hurt me always. Stones and sticks break only skin. The weapons, the instruments used to hurt somebody. These are stones, bats, these are sticks. They break our physical body. They give wounds, injuries to our physical body skin. While words are ghosts that haunt me. See the fourth one line in the very first stanza, the fourth line here. While words are ghosts that haunt me. Here the poet gives a very fantastic line. It is the best example of metaphor. What is The figure of speech, metaphor means here when two unlike things are compared. Implicitly, if they are like the same or two things, here he gives the two things are same one. In this figure of speech is called as a metaphor. And the fourth line, five words are ghost that haunt me. Here poet compares words with ghost. Two unlike things are compared in the same line. And it is called as a figure of speech, metaphor. See, in the next stanza, slant and curve, the fall words, words. Slant and curve, these are the adjective used by poet here to explain the work of words, painful words or harsh words, bad words. These are like a swords. Swords, what is the function of sword? What is the work of sword? It pierces through our physical body. It makes two parts in anything. And so like this, words has also done. Slant and curved fall words. The slant means here, the meaning of slant, it is a slope to one side. Slant words which we are used in our day-to-day life to give hurt to another person. It gives injury to another person. And curve, we use also such kind of a slant and curve words. When we wanted to give somebody pain, when we wanted to give somebody hurt, when we wanted to hurt someone's mind, at that time we emphatically use such kind of a curved and slant words. And these are like swords. Poet compared curved and slant words like a curve here, like a sword here. Sword, it goes, pierce through, or part, for example, in Marathi. It to pierce and stick inside me. Such kind of a harsh words, such kind of a hard word, bad words, pierce our mind. Our mind, heart is very delicate, very soft corner it is. It is very tender, and so it does such kind of a harsh words, such kind of a painful words, such kind of a bad words, pierce and stick inside me. We can't easily forget the hurt given by such kind of a slant words, such kind of a curved words, and the words, the given injury, such kind of a words, pain given through the words, it remains forever, for a long time. Bats and bricks may etch through bones, but words can mortify me. Bats and bricks may etch through bones. Bats, sticks, bricks, such kind of a weapons, such kind of a instruments only injure our physical body, skin, bones. But words can mortify me. What is the meaning of mortify? Make one feel ashamed. It gives such kind of a pain. We can't forget it for a long time. We can't forget easily. And so such kind of a words can mortify. Mortify means feel ashamed. Make one feel ashamed. Enthusiastically, we can use such kind of a words, slant words, curved words. We wanted to feel ashamed the person in front of you, and in such a way, such kind of a words mortify me. Pain from words has left its scar. What is the meaning of scar? Scar means mark. Scar means here, it is given the meaning of scar means mark, wound. It is a mark of any wound which is given to our body. And pain from words has left its scar. The pain given through physical body, it may heal some time, after some time. But the pain, the hurt given by such kind of a harsh words, bad words, it can't easily heal, can't recover easily. and it remains for a long time. We can't forget our insult and we disturb for a long period. The pain given through the words, we can't easily forget such kind of an insult, such kind of a pain given by the hard words, given by the harsh words, bad words. And we can't forget it easily. It lives, it remains for a long time. And we disturb when we heard such kind of a painful words from another person. At that time, it disturbs for a long time. And it can't heal, it can't recover easily, or it can't be recovered for a short time of period. It lives forever, it lives for a long time. And so pain from words has left its scar on mind and heart that tender. Our very delicate part of our human body is our mind. At the very last stanza, poet compared painful, harsh words and the mind, the pain, the mark given through such kind of a painful words or harsh words, it is on our mind and it can't be easily healed. The pain given through the instruments like bats, stones, sticks, bats, it is easily healed, it is easily recovered. But the hurt, the injury given through such kind of a painful words, such kind of a harsh words, bad words, hard words, we can't easily recover, we can't easily heal. And here angry and harsh words are injure, hurt like a sword, like swords, they injure our heart, they injure our mind also. The poet says that damage caused by the harsh language, harsh or painful language, is more than damage caused by bats, sticks or stones, the physical injury. It is more than the pain given through such kind of a harsh words, is more than the damage caused by our physical body, physical injury. And here, according to the poet, words cause more damage than physical injury, and so the poet wants us, here poet again and again gives a very good lesson, moralistic kind of a lesson he wanted to give us. According to poet, we also, poet wants we keep in our mind that we use very kind, gentle words when we speak with another person. While speaking, we should use words very carefully and properly. He wanted to give such kind of a very good lesson, because harsh and bitter words are like a slant and curved swords. They deeply injure our heart, they deeply injure our sentiments, emotions, they deeply injure our mind. And such kind of a wounds, such kind of a scar is not healed for a short period of time. It is remains forever. It remains for a long time. And so here poet again and again gives a very moralistic kind of a lesson that we should use very gentle, kind words while speaking. When we speak with another person, we take care, we keep it in our mind that we have to be used, we should use proper words while speaking. Thank you all of you. Here, okay, only one point is remaining here. Here poet wanted to, here poet uses another two figure of speeches, alliteration and repetition. In the very first stanza, here in the very first line, slant, sticks and stones may break my bones. In the very first line, poet uses alliteration. What is the meaning of alliteration? When the words are repeated in the same line, when two words or one or more than one words are repeated in the same line, it is called as a alliteration. Figure of speech is called as a alliteration, and it is used in the very first line. And repetition, another one figure of speech, it is a repetition, it is figure of speech in which the same sound is repeated one sound is repeated in the same line. Sound is repeated, it is called as a repetition, and the words are repeated, it is called as a alliteration. You have to be remember such kind of a figure of speeches which is used by Barry Gardner here. First one is metaphor, it is used in the fourth line, the first stanza. While words are ghost that haunt me, and in the very first line, sticks and stones may break my bones. It is used in the it is one of the figure of speech alliteration. And then slant and curved, the fall words. It is one of the example of repetition. Repetition means the same sound is repeated, and alliteration means the same words is repeated in the whole line or the whole sentence. Are you understood, students? Thank you all of you.